So in this first case, we have three columns, student name, teacher name, and the student's grade. But one of the rules for normalization is that we have to have a unique key that says what each row is about. But names aren't unique. If we have two students named Jake Smith, or Pavel Ivanov, or something else, this isn't going to do very well. Also, if a student is taking two courses taught by the same teacher, like maybe a CS and a math course, we'll have problems there too. So this is not normalized. Over here we also have a single table. Here we've given each student a unique ID number, and we're also using a unique ID for courses instead of just the teacher's name. But we're storing facts that don't have to do with each other in the same table. Like student 23 is always Jake Smith, regardless of what course he's taking. This really ought to be split into two tables, so this is also not normalized. And splitting it into two tables is exactly what we've done in this third group. One table that gives the relationship between each student ID and their name, and the other gives the grade for each course they take. If all we know is a student's name, we can join this against that to find their courses, but if there are two students with the same name, we will get both. Nonetheless, this is normalized. And the fourth group, the only difference between this one and that one is that here we're also keeping track of students' birth dates. But a person only has one birth date, and the birth date doesn't have anything to do with their grades. So adding this column to this table doesn't make this any less normalized than this one. So this and this are both normalized.